Welcome to another episode of Chalk Talk, presented by Relax Teams. Here is Understanding Auto Insurance with Dennis Harabin.
Hello, my name is Dennis Harabin, and I'm here to help you to better understand your insurance. Before you can customize your insurance for exactly what you need, it's important to understand what it is and what you have and how you go about getting it. So a lot of people, everyone has the insurance, but not everyone understands what all the abbreviations mean. So BI, that's your bodily injury. That actually protects another individual when you have an accident. So that's the cost of bodily injury to others. It's often shown with one number over a second number. As an example, 250 over 500. 250 would be $250,000 maximum for bodily injury per person. And then the maximum for the entire accident with all the people would be 500. So the top number is per person, second number is per accident. Next, you have your property damage. Property damage is for damage done to other people's property. Finally, then there's the PIP coverage, which is often confused. That is your personal injury protection. That is, in many states like New Jersey, is referred to as no fault. So it covers your medical coverage regardless of who's at fault for people in your vehicle. The UM is for underinsured and uninsured motorists. So the increase in that that increases the coverage of an underinsured person or an uninsured person to the amount that you opt for in this coverage. This coverage is maxed out by the amount of coverage that you provide to others. So you can only cover yourself to the extent you cover the liability to others. And that's your UM insurance. Now moving on to some of the optional coverages. Your optional coverages would include your collision. The collision is basically covers the amount over your deductible for damage to your vehicle. So if you don't have collision and something happens, then you're not covered, but it'll cover your personal vehicle. Comprehensive is the amount of your vehicle that is covered for everything that isn't a collision. And again, that's over and above the amount of deductible. Deductible is basically self-insurance. So you're selecting how much you're going to cover on your own, which reduces the overall rates every year for your policy. Because you're insuring a piece of that on yourself. So a deductible can go from no deductible up to $2,000 or more. So it's about how much you want to self-insure is the deductible, and these coverages cover over above that deductible. There's towing and labor, which provides a fixed amount per incident. So basically, if you break down, you need to have your car towed or someone come out and work on it quickly. It covers the amount of that towing and labor costs, and it's a set amount. One thing people don't realize, though, those are claims against your policy when you do make a claim for a towing incident. And then rental coverages are, provides a fixed amount of coverage for so many days and a total amount per a period of time, usually 30 days in a month. And it's if your car is in an accident. This isn't if you're just going on a vacation or something, you want to take a rental car. It is for when your car is in an accident, this is the amount of coverage you have. So that's a basics. If you have any questions, I know this was brief, I'll answer all your questions. What do you want to know about insurance? Give me a call, text me 908-300-3221. Dennis Harabin, have a great day.
It's natural to still have questions. Call or text 908-300-3221 and speak to Dennis Harabin.